नमस्कार, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। आज के वेबिनार सीरीज में हमारे साथ डॉक्टर शिवानंद पाटिल सर। बहुत दिनों से हम लोग इस वेबिनार के लिए वेट कर रहे थे, ऑर्गेनाइज करने का हम काफी दिनों से प्रयास कर रहे थे, बट ड्यू टू मेनी रीजंस लाइक समय और बहुत सारी कुछ बातें होती थी, तो बट आई थिंक टुडे इज द मोस्ट अवेटेड डे फॉर ट्राइकोलॉजी। So I welcome Dr. Shivanand Patil sir on this platform of Ayush Darpan. And before starting the session, we would like to pray for God, Dhanvantari, Bhagwan Dhanvantari ko hum naman karte hain aur yahan par main sabhi ko aage is satr ko chalaye.
नमामि धन्वन्तरि वाणि देवं सुरासुरैः वन्दित पाद पद्मम् लोके जरा शङ्खं चक्रं च लोकां दधतं मृतघटं चारुतुर्भिश्चतुर्भिः सूक्ष्मस्वच्छादिरुद्यं शुकपरिविलसन् मौलिमं भोजनेत्रम्
is a trust which is working for the propagation of Ayurveda, and we are organizing since last 1.5 years these webinars, and many webinars are organized by this foundation. So today is the psychology ek alag se section hai Ayurveda mein, aur jaise ki sir aap kaam kar rahe hain to kafi dinon se aapko sunne ki ichha thi, hamare platform ke logon ki bhi aur bahut sare logon ki demand thi, kyunki aaj hum dekhenge ki Ayurveda ke sath sath जैसे कि ब्यूटी तो ऑल टाइम सभी के फेवरेट होती ही है, हर कोई चाहता है, बट उसके लिए हमें आयुर्वेद के साथ किस प्रकार से जोड़ना है, क्या करने हैं, प्रैक्टिस मॉडर्न तरीके क्या है, तो इसको लेकर हमने ये आज का सेशन रखा है। तो सर डॉक्टर शिवानंद पाटिल सर हैज कंप्लीटेड हिज ग्रेजुएशन फ्रॉम द बेलगांव, एंड देन ही कंप्लीटेड हिज एमडी फ्रॉम द कोपा एंड पीएचडी फ्रॉम तिलक महाराष्ट्र कॉलेज पुणे। Also, sir has completed PGDMT from Germany, PGDMC also from the Germany. Sir has completed the diploma in medical cosmetology, diploma in cosmetology. इसके साथ साथ सर ने कुछ awards भी सर को मिले हैं, like Panaka International Excellence Award, then Sadhak Vashishta Ayurveda Ratna Dhanvantari Award, so many awards. तो बहुत सारे
ऊपर legs fold कर
आयुर्वेदा। इसके साथ साथ काफी बुक्स भी सर ने लिखे हैं, लाइक आनंदी जीवन, आयुर्वेदिक साइकोलॉजी, आयुर्वेदिक डर्मेटोलॉजी, आयुर्वेदिक कॉस्मेटोलॉजी, सेक्स आफ्टर 40। सो वंस अगेन आई वेलकम डॉक्टर शिवानंद पाटिल सर ऑन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ आयुष दर्पण, एंड रिक्वेस्ट सर टू स्टार्ट द सेशन। यस सर, आई विल मेक यू को होस्ट। यस
So, good afternoon to all. So, in the beginning, I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Ayush Darpan Foundation, especially the founder, Vaidya Naveen Joshi ji, and very energetic, enthusiastic the organizer and a moderator of Ayush Darpan Foundation, Dr. Shilpa Arame Madam. So last time also we tried to arrange the webinar session, but due to some unavoidable circumstances, it was not able to happen. So today we are going to have a keen look into the Ayurveda and the advanced treatments in the trichology. So it's one request from my side, madam. Please mute.
Yes, sir. I have muted. Yes, I have muted all, sir. Yes.
It's a request, Dr. Yes Khan.
Yes, please, sir. Sabhi logon ko request hai, please mute yourself. After the search session over, we will go for the question answer also. So please, it's request to all to mute your mics, please.
Okay, sir. It will be disturbing the session.
Yes, I will.
Okay, yes, sir. Open. I will share the screen.
Sir, you can share, sir. You are co-host.
Yes. So, a very warm welcome to all future trichologists, that's Ayurvedic trichologists, to the session. So, this session is going to be an innovative session where I will be dealing with role of Ayurveda and advanced in a trichology. Because this is my efforts is to integrate the Ayurveda with advanced modalities. And we are very successful by integration of these two faculties, and the results are amazing. So all the secrets which I am practicing since last 15 years, so that all the secrets today I will be going to share you. And at the end of the session, we can have a question and answer session. Nothing to put on the chat box, directly you can raise the questions at the end of the session. The first is, what is the trichology? Okay, the term itself indicates trichology, trichon. So that is the hairs, and the science which is dealing with the hairs is the trichology. Now, what is the importance? Importance is very, very, very important now. See, 21st century is of the glamorous century. So where a lot of, everyone want to be look beautiful. In that, the role of hairs and the trichology plays a very important role. No one can assess themselves without the hairs. Because we are getting the patients starting from the age of 4 up to the age of 67 to 70. So this is a range what we are getting the patients every day. So before going to the exact topic, so I would like to share my clinical experience. Because very important, talking is not important. Showing the results is very important. So I would like to demonstrate some of the cases which we treated in last 15 years. In that, different modality of the cases I will be discussing. In that, as everybody knows, I am running 6 clinics in 3 states. So that is the Maharashtra, Karnataka, and the Goa. So this patient lady came to me in my Goa center to see the result. The patient who came to me, the patient was having the alopecia totalis. Again, we are going to discuss different types of the hair disorders. Okay. So alopecia, this was the first condition when the patient came to me. So this was the photographs taken on the day one. Okay. So day one is the photographs taken. This was the condition when the patient came to me. See, we are always taking the photographs from 4 sides. This is the frontal. See, photos will be taken front side, vertex, right lateral, left raptor. So these are all the 4 photographs are taken from the patient. Along with that, so we are doing the investigations. And after doing the investigation, it has been observed that a patient had some nutritional deficiency. Okay, because this is how to assess the cases and everything we are going to discuss later. So this patient came to us, we started giving the medicines, and I think we treated her for 6 months. And after the 6 months, what we got is this. The patient was getting a total 100% results of the hair loss. If you see here, again the same photographs we took, that is frontal side, occipital, right lateral, left lateral. So these photographs are taken and just see before and after. So this was only by following Ayurveda treatments. Some internal medications, Panchakarma protocols, when we are following. So this is going to happen. See here, the case one, where the patient was not having a single hairs. After 6 months, total hairs, patient got total hairs back. See this right lateral condition, left lateral. So this indicates after giving the medicines for 6 months, patient was regaining all the hairs. So this was the first case which I want to demonstrate. So the patient has some nutritional deficiency along with the hair disorders. Somebody is having Dr. Rame Madam, please mute. Everybody, please keep muted. So here, the second case which came to us was in my Kolhapur center. See, this boy is a 14 years boy. He has an alopecia totalis, and mainly along with the alopecia totalis, he had this hypothyroidism. So hypothyroidism was the condition when the patient came to us, and patient was under the treatment of the endocrinologist. Patient was taking the treatment from the endocrinologist, but patient was not getting the results. And the endocrinologist referred the patient to me. I started the treatment for this. See all these conditions, some the patients who took the photographs. And again, after 6 months, what we got is this. Again, total hairs we regained back through Ayurveda medicines, Panchakarma, and some advanced protocols. See here. If you see the before and after the photographs of the patients, so total within 6 months, total scenario has been changed. See here, right lateral condition, left this occipital backside of the ears. So this was the second condition when the patient had the hypothyroidism along with the alopecia totalis. Third patient, see the before and after. The patient came to us with a female pattern of the hair loss. This is very commonly present in the menopausal stage. It starts generally from the premenopausal stage, and we started giving the medicines. You can see the visible results. So this took nearly 3.5 months, and within that, patient got the results. This is a patient in our Sangli clinic. Swananda Tambekar. See, this result is a male pattern of the virus, which in detail we are going to discuss. And these results, what we got is within 2 months. Patient is under still under the treatment, and within 2 months, patient got the results for the male pattern of the hair loss. Second, next patient was to our Mumbai clinic. Aniket Ramane was the patient. See, again, this is a typical condition of a male pattern of the baldness. Again, see, the photographs are taken from four corners. This was the actual condition when the patient came to us. And after 6 months, what the patient got is this. you can see before and after treatment which has been given to the patient. And here, remember, as I'm going to disclose the mode of treatment, so we are not giving any kind of oral medicines. See here. All these cases, success stories we are sharing. And this is a very, very rare case I'm sharing with you all. So this is of the patient came to me. She's a 15 years girl. And she lost hair suddenly within a month. But this is one of the cause. So that is any sudden trauma, any psychological trauma to the patient, that will impact the patient. And the patient will lose the hair instantly. This was the case when the patient came to me. See, actually this is the female pattern of the hair loss. This case generally present to us when the patient attains the menopause. But she was a 15 years girl and she had this typical female pattern of hair loss. And see the results. So this patient required a psychosomatic counseling. So we had a very good counseling to the patients. Along with that, we give the medicines, Panchakarma treatment and the machines. So this combination worked excellently to this patient. You can see the miraculous changes in the patient. Okay, so these are what I want to show you initially in the beginning of the class. So that is, these are the possibilities when we are adopting Ayurveda in a very scientific way. Okay. So now I will be dealing with you all hair disorders. So in that hair disorder, the first was the telogen effluvium. So this is also called as a diffuse hair loss. Always we have to remember one case. When the patient is coming to us, patient is having two symptoms. Either patient will come to us with instant hair loss. Patient will tell you that everything was okay. No hair problems were there. Suddenly within a couple of weeks, patients start to get the severe hair fall. So this, when the patient is telling you, so that is a severe sudden hair fall, so that patient lands into the telogen effluvium. But another condition is, the patient will tell you that there's a slowly hair loss. So that is a, that condition is called as a gradual thinning of the hair. So this gradual hair loss is a condition when it goes to the male and female pattern of the bodies. So this we have to differentiate. When the patient is coming to us with a simple symptom of telogen effluvium or a simple hair fall, we have to differentiate whether it is a telogen effluvium condition or it is a male-female pattern of the bodies. This is the first hair disorder. Second is a dandruff. Dandruff considered to be the very simple disease, but it is a very tricky disease. Several times it has been observed that the patient comes to us with the hair fall, but patient will never tell you that patient is having dandruff, because a dry dandruff is very possible to analyze, because patient will tell you the history that scratching is there, itching is there, and mainly flakings are there. So these are the symptoms patient will present you. But in the wet dandruff, patient will never having any kind of the itching. Patient will not be having the scaling. So this is the condition when the patient comes to us. Here is the exact, modality for us to find out whether the patient is having the dry dandruff or the oily dandruff. Next is male and the female pattern of the baldness. So the male pattern of the baldness, as we know, this is the condition
with the
testosterone.
Ma'am,
Dhanashree ma'am, please keep your mic mute ma'am.
Please, it disturbs the session. Everybody should aware. Yes. So again, we will go to the male and female pattern of the baldness. So in the male pattern of the baldness, the condition is related with the testosterone. In previous days, you know, when the patient attains the age of 40, 40 plus, at that time, patient was suffering with the male pattern of the baldness. So due to the lack of the testosterone. But nowadays, we are getting the patients, early adulthood patients, other patients with the 25, 30 years old. So that is due to the increase of the testosterone. Because testosterone is very important. So when the testosterone increases beyond its limits, it becomes a dihydrotestosterone. And when it becomes a dihydrotestosterone, it blocks the hair follicles. And due to the blocking of the hair follicles, so there will be the baldness. So that we are calling it as a male pattern of the hair loss. In the same way, female pattern of the baldness. So again, as we know, this male and the female pattern of the baldness, it totally depends upon your the hormonal factor. Because all these hormones have the typical impact on your hair cycle. Anagen, catagen and telogen. This hair cycle is having a direct impact on this hormone. Next, we are going to the alopecia area. So there are different kinds of alopecias are present. So in that, the first kind of the alopecia is the alopecia areata. So when there is a single patch in the scalp, we are calling it as the alopecia areata. Sometimes it may come to the beard area, it is alopecia barbae. But when it affects the more than 70% of the scalp, so we are calling the condition of the alopecia totalis. As I demonstrated initially, all these cases were from the alopecia totalis. They had a 90 to 95% baldness. Okay. One more condition is coming that is called as alopecia universalis. So in the alopecia universalis, patient loses hairs from all over the body. Means there is no single hair anywhere, eyebrows, everything, all the hairs are lost. Next condition is, three conditions are there, scalp psoriasis, tinea capatis, seborrheic dermatitis. So these conditions we have to differentiate. When the patient is coming to us with any patch in the scalp, we have to differentiate these particular patches. As we know, scalp psoriasis is the condition where, so there is scaling will be there, silvery nature will be there, thickness of the skin will be there. So these are the very common lakshanas are present with these cases. In the tinea capatis, whenever we call it as the tinea, always there are circular patches with the raised marks. Okay. In the psoriasis, there is a flaking will be there, itching will be there, silvery scales will be there. But in the tinea, there is no flaking, no silvery scales. Only there is a itching. And always all tinea patches, they are circular in nature with the raised margin. Okay. Then next is seborrheic dermatitis. So seborrheic dermatitis is a very typical condition where the patient will have the exudes which are yellowish in nature. We call it yellowish crusts. Okay. So these three things we have to differentiate in the hair disorders. Next is a trichotillosis. Again, it is a very rare condition. So trichotillosis is what? Again, this is having the influence of the psychological origin. Sometimes patients, without their knowledge, they are start to pluck the hairs. They are plucking the hair continuously without their knowledge. In that condition is called as a trichotillosis. And this will end up into the scaring alopecia. Okay, where it will produce the patches in the scalp region. And last is the graying of the hairs. Again, this is a very burning issue nowadays. But fortunately, we are treating the graying of the hairs very successfully. If the patient is having the age before 30 age, before 20, we are treating the cases 100% by simple correcting the pathology, doing the samprapti vikatan. So these are the hair disorders which you can get in your trichology OPD. So this you have to know, telogen effluvium, dandruff, male-female pattern baldness, alopecias, scalp psoriasis, tinea capatis, seborrheic dermatitis, traction alopecia. This we forgot. What is a traction alopecia? When when the mother is putting the ponytail to the kids. So she is continuously pulling the hairs and putting the ponies. So this everyday continuous stretching of the hairs, so that will lead to the tractional alopecia. Okay. Then trichotillosis and graying of the hairs. So these are the conditions you can get in our OPD. And fortunately, we can treat all these conditions 100% with Ayurveda. Next, very important point everybody should know, that is the hair cycle. What is the hair cycle? So we are having the three phases. First is the anagen, second is the catagen, third is the telogen. Okay, what is the anagen? Whatever hairs are present on your scalp, presently whatever hairs you are carrying, all these hairs are in the anagen stage. Generally, 1.5 to 2 lakh hairs we are having on the scalp. So these are all in the growing phase. Anagen phase is the growing phase. Okay. So after anagen, the stage comes the catagen stage. So the catagen stage is a stage where the hair leaves the hair unit. Just it detaches the dermal papillae. So dermal papilla is the foremost area of the hair unit. It detaches, very little it detaches, that is the catagen phase. So after that, there is a telogen phase. In the telogen, what is happening? So the hairs are coming out, and from the behind, another hair is coming. So this is called as a telogen phase. So therefore, I'm calling it as the telogen effluvium. So telogen effluvium is a condition where the hairs are falling off and new hairs are not coming up. So that is a stage what we have to remember. It is a telogen phase. So patient will come to you either in catagen phase or the telogen phase. And by giving them medicines, you have to take these cases to the anagen phase. Okay. Then which are the causes? Always remember one point very important. Whenever the patient is coming to us with a typical presentation, okay, plain hair fall is there, nothing to worry. But as we are getting very challenging patients, presently I am treating six alopecia universalis cases. So where the patient is not having a single hair on their throughout the body. So these are the cases when they are coming to you. Please do proper analysis and go to the main causes. The first cause for all the hair disorders is the nutritional deficiency. It may be anemia, it may be due to the pregnancy, lack of ferritin, B12 and the calcium. Always we have to do proper investigations. Second cause is the hormonal imbalance, mainly thyroid, especially the hypothyroidism, PCOS or the testosterone. Either testosterone is picked up or it is going down. Both the conditions, it is very bad for the hair. If it is going more, it becomes a DHT, it blocks the hair follicles and problem starts. But if it is coming back, it will not stimulate the hair follicles, that will result into the, again, baldness. So these are all the points we have to understand. Next is the stress. Remember, as we are getting a lot of, when I go to Pune, Mumbai and Goa, there we are getting a lot of patients who are having the sedentary lives, IT, especially IT people. So they are more stressed out. So this stress, what is the stress? So this stress hormones impacts your hair cycle. The damage, the production and regulation maintenance of the anagen phase. So therefore, all these patients having the stress, they have to be treated by anti-stressing treatments. Then the seasonal changes. As we know, hairs are the first unit, those who are getting exposed to the environment. Okay, so environmental impact is mainly on the hair follicles. as in Ayurveda, it is called a Rutu Sandhi. In each and every Rutu Sandhi, there are the chances to get the hair falls. Next is the pollution. What is happening with the pollution? As you know, pollution contains maximum the carbon dioxide. And this carbon dioxide dries your scalp. See, we are driving the bikes, we are going outside, we are walking, we are moving in the marketplaces. After exposing ourselves, so this, whatever the carbon is present due to the heavy traffic, so that carbon, the pollution is coming on the scalp. First is it dries the sebum. It dries the nutrition. And as there is a drying of the sebum, scalp become very dry. And that will lead to the hair problems. Styling agents. As you know, a lot of youngsters, those who are coming to you, they are using a lot of straightening gels for the different hairstyles. Whatever the styling agents, every agent contains the chemicals. What is the role of the chemicals? So all these styling agents will damage the cuticle of the hairs. You are applying externally, and once cuticle is getting damaged, so this will go inside and damage the cortex and the medulla of the hair follicle. So we may think that is nothing problem, we are applying 1 or 2 days, but this long-term application definitely cures, it kills the superficial protecting layer of the cuticle. And hair care products, as you know, in India, we are more prone to get the cheap products, but always discount products. But always remember, if you want to purchase anything for your cosmetics, if you want to purchase anything which is to make you very glamorous, never go to discount products or the low quality products. If you want to use for the scalp, it should be sulfate free. These sulfates damages the hairs. If you want to use anything for your skin, it should be paraben free. So therefore, use always good quality products. Then we'll go to the next point, a diagnosis. How you have to diagnose? First, as I told you previously, when you're such a critical patients are coming to you, first you have to evaluate. Without evaluation, you will never get the results. The first, you have to find out the infectious stages, CBC and the ESR. Several times it is observed that when the patient is having the chronic fever, it may be typhoid fever, dengue, whatever the fever patient is having. So due to that increase of temperature in the body, it burns the hair follicles. Due to the burning of the hair follicles, the patient will go to the hair loss. So first we have to evaluate whether there is any infection. Second, we have to go to the, we have to check the nutritional status of the body. Check the serum ferritin, check your serum ferritin, B12, serum calcium. So these are the things which are very important. To it will give the crystal clear idea what is the state of the nutrition. Generally, it is observed that vitamin B12 is having the deficiency of the vegetarian people, because the vegetarians, we don't have much sources of vitamin B12. Several times patient will tell you that my HB is very good, CBC count is very good, but this CBC or HB does not have any value in the trichological diagnosis. We have to go to the micronutrient, that is ferritin. Okay, ferritin is the component which reaches to each and every hair unit and nurtures the hair follicles. So that we have to understand. So second, after infection, we have to check the nutritional status. And lastly, we have to analyze the hormonal imbalance. First, it comes in your mind is a testosterone. We have to check whether it's more or less than the thyroid profile. In the females, you can go with the estrogen, progesterone, and the follicle stimulating hormones. So these are also very necessary for the diagnosis. Without diagnosis of the cases, please, please, please don't continue the cases. Next is, after giving the proper diagnosis, next tool is you have to analyze the case. Local analysis. Okay. So in that, first is a hair pull test. What is hair pull test? So you have to, in the thumb and the index finger, you have to take 15 to 20 hairs. And gently you have to pull the hairs. When gently you are pulling the hairs, if more than 50% hairs are coming in your hand, that indicates there is hypodermal circulation. That indicates hair follicles are not getting proper blood circulation. So there is no proper stimulation. So that indicates instant treatment to the patient. It may be external or the internal. Second and very important is the tracheoscopic analysis. It is observed that as general used to tell to all my students. So as in the general practice, stethoscope is so important. In the same way, being a trichologist, tracheoscope is important. Without having the tracheoscope, you cannot diagnose the cases. Why? See. So I will be demonstrating you some of the findings. The first case, alopecia areata. See, please try to see it very keenly. So here you can see all the alopecia areata. You can see all small hair openings. Hair openings are there, but hair unit is absent. What it indicates? It indicates just you have to stimulate the hair follicles, either internally or externally. Once you are stimulating the hair follicles, yes, you will get the results. Okay. And so many times patient will ask you, doctor, whether I will get the results. If you do the tracheoscope properly, if such a condition is there, you can directly promise the patient, yes, you can get hairs back. Because hair follicles are already there. Only you have to stimulate the hair follicles. But see the next case. In the male pattern and female pattern of the baldness. See, please try to differentiate both the conditions. See here, you can see the openings. Here, everything is blocked. In this male-female pattern of the baldness, nothing is visible. Why? Because due to the increase of the testosterone or decrease of the testosterone, your hair follicles are blocked. And as the hair follicles are blocked, so there the scalp is totally blocked. So there is no regaining, regrowth of the hair follicles. So in such a cases, patient will take longer duration of a treatment. First, once you are treating the testosterone, you are either it is increased, you have to decrease. If it is decreased, you have to increase. After correction of the testosterone, again, your scalp will become like this. Okay. Then slowly hair follicles will come out. Next is the dandruff. So many times the patient will tell you that I don't have a dandruff. I don't have any itching, but I am having the hair fall. Why? Because see here, at the base of each and every hair follicle, so there are the flakes. This is the oily dandruff. In the oily dandruff, excess sebum and the oil of the hair unit and the dry dandruff, both they are coming together and they are packing, blocking the hair unit. And due to that, you are not getting the results. Okay. So this is a false representing of the cases. So to diagnose, you have to do the tracheoscopic analysis, which is very important. So what are the things you have to adopt? First, you have to do proper analysis, blood and investigation. Second, you have to do the pull test and you have to do the tracheoscopic studies. And then the classifications. The first is a Norwood classification, especially in the males. Okay. So as we know, males bald from the frontal region. So they bald from the frontal region slowly. It goes to the recession. just check out here, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 4, grade 5. Slowly the hair follicles are going back, back, back. So after the grade of 3, then occipital involvement will start. Okay. And before promising the patients, we should know our limitations. What we can do by Ayurveda. Ayurveda, you can do up to the grade 5. Grade 4. Up to the grade 4, we can treat by pure Ayurveda. After that, you have to go to the air transfer. Okay. So this is the thing we have to see. Just see here. Initially, it started from the frontal line. And then, at the third stage, it impacted the vertex. But in the women's, it is totally different. What is happening in the woman? It is the Ludwig classification. Females, generally, when they attain the menopause, during the menopause, they are losing the hair from their scalp, special vertex area. Grade 1, grade 2, type 1, type 2, up to 5. Slowly, it is spreading from the vertex, thinning will start. Okay. And fortunately, in the females, we can treat all 5 gradations by Ayurveda. Okay. While in the males, we can treat up to the grade 5. Now, next point is very important, management. Okay. So, we have seen the success stories. We have seen the causes. We have seen the diagnosis. Now, matter of the management. How we have to treat such cases. So, how we are doing the treatment since last 15 years. The first is the internal medication. Second is the external treatment. Again, external treatment is divided into 2 categories. First is for the hair loss. Second is for the hair regrowth. And what is my specialty and our contribution is the integration. That what we are going to discuss. One more concept we have to remember when we are going to give the internal medicine to the patient. Several times we commit a mistake. Why? Because we adopt the modern principles. When the patient is coming to us with the hair fall, we are giving the multivitamins, we are giving the calciums, we are giving the biotins, we are giving the minoxidil, we are doing all the things. But if you think about Ayurveda, it is totally wrong. We should not follow these principles. So there is a different principle which he adopted. And I am giving them to the patients and patients are getting the results miraculously, which already shown. So there is one concept which I developed. So that is a Kosha, Shrotas and the Dha. So this concept is our strength. So whenever you are going to treat the patients, where is the problem? Asti Dhatu Mala is a Kesha. Problem is in the Asti Dhatu. But here we should not give directly medicine to Asti Dhatu. You have to come to the Shrotas. Then you have to come to the Kosha. Why we have to follow this principle? Charak, Shushrut, Vagbhat, Chakrapani, Dalan. All Tikakaras and our Acharyas told one beautiful line of a treatment. If you want to treat any hair disorders, it may be any. It may be Khalityo, Palityo, Indralutyo. In modern science, Talogen Ephraim, dandruff, male female pattern baldness, whatever patient's hair problems are there, you have to treat only 2 conditions. First, Koshthagata Pitta and Srotogata Dehoshma. Crystal clear treatment has been told in our Granthas. What is that? Always remember, why there are a lot of hair problems are coming. That is due to the disturbed the Kosha. Okay. So here when you are going to start giving the medicines, first medicine to the Kosha, then the Srotas, then to the Dhatus. Okay. So what is the Kosha? Kosha is what? Kusha plus Tham. Anything, any empty space, which is covered by the lining, It is called a kosha. It may be a cell. Each and every cell is having the linings. That each and every cell is also called as a kosha. But mahakosha, that is whole of your digestive tract. So this is also called as the kosha. Okay. So here you have to treat this mahakosha first. Then you have to go to the srotas. What is the srotas? Su sravane srotamsi. Means what? Anything which flows all over the body. What flows? Rasa and the rakta. So these are in the watery media or these are liquid media. So they are having the capabilities to spread all over the body. So after the kosha, you have to treat the srotas. Because whatever medicines you are giving, whatever diet you are giving, everything is getting carried out by the srotas. Cleaning of the srotas is very important. Once your srotas is very good, fine, then you have to target the dhatus. That is mansa medha asthi. And then asthi mala is a kesh. That wise you have to move it. Don't focus only on the asthi dhatu. Okay. So this is what beautifully you are giving the treatments. And my students across the globe, so they are following this line of a treatment and most of them are very successful. Remember only two things. One is a pitta, second is a devoshma. Now how to give the medicines? So when the patient is coming to you, first you have to focus on the digestive tract. Okay, so this is stomach. We have to focus on the stomach. So first, etiology starts from the kosha. As it is told in the granthas, increase the pitta. Why the pitta is getting increased? First cause is the stress. Why early age, all the IT people, youngsters, they are having this baldness. First is the stress. What is happening by the stress? So stress influences your vagus nerve. As we know, vagus nerve is supplying your whole digestive tract. What is the role of the vagus nerve? To stimulate. It continuously stimulates. What it stimulates in the stomach? It stimulates gastric flora. It stimulates parietal cells. And these parietal cells stimulates HCL. So when you are continuously stressed without the food, in your intestine, without the food in the stomach, there is the HCL. So that will damage your gastric flora. That will increase the localized pitta. This you have to remember. Number two, ahara. As we know, so we now recently we are found of taking the outside foods. We are doing a lot of hotelings. We are eating lots of street foods, vada pav and the bhaji and the Chinese, lot of things we are stuffing. Remember, everything is and toxic in nature because you know they are frying the oil more and more time and this becomes carcinogenic. And so this everything when you are eating, so this again damages your gastric. So therefore, ahara and the vihara, stress, everything as they are damaging your localized pitta, your first line of a treatment should be correct localized pitta. Medicine first should be given to correct the localized pitta. See, I am just giving you the principles. What medicines are there? You can take according to your own yukti. Okay. First is the pitta shamana in the amashaya. Second, you have to give the ama pachana because that ama is also very important. What is ama? Ama is something which is near to the poison. So if it is near to the poison, it is a toxin. And this metabolic waste toxins will produce the free radicals. And these free radicals develop the hair disorders. So therefore, ama pachaka aushadhi is you have to give. Next is the Vata anulomana chikitsa. Apaniyate apana. Apana vata is very important. So that whatever metabolic waste, toxins, fecal matter, everything should be eliminated out from the body. If there is no proper elimination, again that will remain in the intestine, toxins, free radicals, diseases. Therefore, you have to analyze the koshta of the patient. Kura, Madhyama, and the Mrudu Koshta. So according to the Koshta, you have to give the Vatanuloma Kaushalyas. So these are three medicines. Next is, from day one, you have to give the medicine for the target disease. As you know, there are two nayas are explained in Ayurveda. The first is the Kalekapota Nyaya. Second is the Kedara Kulya Nyaya. Kalekapota Nyaya means what? One medicine should be given directly to the Asti Dhatu for nourishment of the Kesha. And that is the Kalekapota Nyaya. Second is the Kedara Kulya Nyaya. That is from Koshta, Srotas, Dhatus. One medicine. And last, always remember, as I told you, one tablet you have to give for the stress throughout your session. You can give Manasmitra Vata. It is the best tablet which I prescribed to all the patients. So here, from the day one, you are treating the stress. You are giving the target drug for the Asti Dhatu. Then you are doing the Pitta Shamana, Amapachana, Vatana. So this medicine for 15 days. Next. Now everything has been clear in the Koshta. Next, you have to come to the Rasa Dhatu and the Rakta Dhatu. So here, Rasa and the Rakta Pachaka Aushadhi is one. Always I tell you, use Pachaka Aushadhi. Charaka Chikitsa Sthana, Jwara Chikitsa. In the Charaka Chikitsa, Jwara Chikitsa, in the end, Charakacharya explained, there are eight kind of the Jwara Nashaka Kashayas. Rasapachaka, Raktapachaka, Mansapachaka, Astipachaka, Majja, Astimajja, Shukha. So these kashayas you have to give. You can give the tablet, you can give the churna, you can give anything they give. What is the role of these pachaka aushadis? This pachaka aushadis stimulates the dhatavagni and they correct the function of the dhatavagni. That is their main role. If your dhatavagni is damaged, whatever medicines you are giving, whatever food you are giving, that is not going to be absorbed from your dhatus. Therefore, pachaka aushadis are very, very, very important. You know, next, after 15 days, when the patient is coming, rasapachana, raktapachana, one drug for the asti dhatu, one is for a stress. I can tell you, when you are giving the such a medicines, see, in the first 15 days, here, we never give any medicine on hairs. But you adopt the principle which I am telling you. Patient will tell you, within a 15 days, patient stop the hair fall. Why it is so? Because you treated Pitta Dosha. Sthanika Pitta. As Charakshushudu Vagvada, Dalana and Chakrapani told, treat first Pitta. Next target is a Rasarakta. Then third target, after 15 days, after 1 month, you have to give Yakurt Uttejaka Aushadis. Because Yakurta is very, very, very important. It is a detoxifying agent. It is having the capacity to regenerate the cells. And it is a transport media through which the nutrition is going to reach to each and every cell in the body. You have to stimulate the liver cells by giving the medicines. Next, see, fourth is after 1.5 months, we are coming to the Asti Dhatu. Here, see, if you want to give multivitamins, after 1.5 months, when the patient is coming to the Yakurt Uttejana, here you have to give the multivitamins. Because all the multivitamins are getting metabolized, utilized, and used by the liver. And then the fourth setting, here you can give the calcium, iron the calcium. Here what is required is the Asti Posha. Okay, and one very interesting thing found as it is told in the Granthas, Asti Dhatu Mala is a Kesha. So surprisingly, when I found the references, if you take the transverse section of the Asti, osteoclasts, and when you take a transverse section of the hair unit, both are same. So therefore, if you are giving the medicine for the Asti Dhatu Vruddhi, so that will nurture your hair you need. So here at the end of second month, you have to give the medicine for asti poshana. And see last, after completion of 2 months, here you are giving keshavardhaka chikitsa. This is the line of a treatment you have to adopt if you want to become effective in your treatment. See, koshta, srotas and dhatus. If you are following this particular sequence, you are going to be a successful tracheologist. So this is about the internal medications. Next, we are going to discuss external treatments. Here, external treatments we divide into two. First, either you can do the panchakarma, and if you don't have the panchakarma set up, then also we are having the hair spa therapy, which you can do in your clinic. In the panchakarma, so I am mainly doing the parisheka chikitsa, which is least given importance in our treatment. But what is a parisheka? It is a kashaya dhama. Here you have to take the dravyas, which are tikta rasa and sheeta virya. See, what is the target here? As I told you, my first pathology was a pitta. Where the pitta? From the koshtagata pitta. Next, we have to treat the dehoshma, as mentioned by the Chakrapani and the Dalan. So if you want to treat interstitial temperature, if you want to treat that dehoshma, you have to do the parisheka. No other solution for it. How to do the parisheka treatment? Take 10 liters of water and add all the shita viryatma, like chandana, ushira, sariva, musta, manjista, all the nimba, haridra, all these drugs you have to add. Detoxifying, purifying, and alkalizing. And you have to boil it. After boil, don't go, just boil. Once it is there, you just filter it. And you have to just pour on the boil. Just pour on the boil. And you see, if you are practicing, if you have the panchakarma setup, you adopt it. And it is observed that you will get astonishingly that on the day of 4 and 5, patient will tell you that my color of urine becomes red. Why it is so? Because whatever you are pouring, that is a manjista. So that is getting absorbed, circulated, and excreted throughout the urine. Means what? Whatever you are pouring from outside of the parisheka, that is getting eliminated out from the body. Therefore, if you just do a research, just do parisheka, only do parisheka for 7 days, hair fall will stop. Why? Because you are treating the dehoshma, pitta and the dehoshma. And a parisheka is the only treatment which can give you the promising results. Second is thing is you can do the chirodhara or the takradhara. See, if you want to give the nutrition to the hair follicles, do chirodhara. But if you are having the stress, musta amala kyadi takradhara is the best. Shirobasti you can adopt. Nasya. Always see, I am not doing the panchakarma nasya. So for the hairs, there should be continuous stimulation. So therefore, we are adopting pratimarsanasya. Every day, the patient has to do the pratimarsanasya, that is in the nisha kala, in the ratri kala. Because in Charaka says, all urdhva chaturgata vikaras, we have to do nisha kala treatments. Okay, so this we have to adopt in our treatment. Now, see, there is a dandruff, you can use the anutailanasya. If there is only plain hair fall, you can use the Eshtimudu Telanasya. If there is an alopecia in here, alopecia totalis, alopecia universalis, then stimulation is required. So there you can do the, Shadbindu Telanasya. And if the patient is having palithya, in that condition, you can do the prapaundarikadi tailanasya. You adopt any tailanasya, nas should be must for 90 days. Then jalavaka vachana. This you can do localize in alopecia. So what sequence I can suggest is, when the patient is coming to one of panchakarma, first you can do the parisheka for 20 minutes, then the abhyanga by the pinda taila, or dhanvantara taila, or kshirabala one or two taila. So you can adopt any, and do the akenda pitta shamani chikitsa. Abhyanga for 20 minutes, takkaradhara for 28 minutes. Then you have to do tiktaka kshirabasti. So this is the sequence you have to follow. So why tiktaka kshirabasti? Tikta is pitta shamaka and kshira is a bruhana. So here, as a head, all hair disorders are originated due to the pitta abnormality. So that will be corrected by doing the tikta kshirabasti, and it will give the nutrition also. So if you are having this panchakarma setup, you can do it. Otherwise, we are having another protocol, that is a home care. This what you can do home care, or you can call the patient at your clinic. This should be done weekly twice. How the procedure goes? Now first, when the patient is coming to you, first there should be shuru abhyanga with acupressure points. Proper shuru abhyanga. See, a lot of people, they tell, no, I am applying the oil. Applying the oil is not important. You take very little quantity of oil, do proper massage. Less oil, proper massage is important. So that will increase the blood circulation, calm, and stimulate the hair follicles. First is shuru abhyanga. Second is the shuru pichu. 20 minutes. Why shuru pichu? Because here you are keeping medicated oil for longer duration. When you expect that a medicine should go deeper inside, at that time we have to adopt the pichu therapy, 20 minutes, and end up into the talam. So this you have to adopt. Shuru abhyanga, pichu, and talam. See, medicines changes. For dandruff, medicine will be different. Hair fall, medicines will be different. Male-female pattern, medicine will be different. Alopecia, medicine will be different. And the palitya, all the medicines are different. But procedure, protocol will remain same. Then you have to give the dhupana. So dhupana is what? Just to stimulate your hair follicle through the nasal orifices. It crosses the cribriform plexus, goes to the third ventricle and reaches the hair follicles. Here you can use the vacha. So burn I can give is, and in severe cases you can adopt the talapodichil treatment also can be adopted for the better results. So this is the home care you have to do on the patients, because home cares are very important. So if you are having the treatments protocol, panchakarma, you can do it. Otherwise, this also is equally important. But definitely, I can suggest you go with the panchakarma. If there is no, then this is good. So this is about the, we discussed external treatments according to Ayurveda. Now here, I am telling you some advanced procedures. See here, what is our specialty is integration of these machines with Ayurveda. First is the procedure for the hair fall. Now here, we have to divide the patients in two categories. Either patient will be having dandruff, hair fall, split end. Second category will be all the alopecias, male female pattern baldness. We are dividing these two cases. Okay. In that, first we are going is dandruff and split ends. So this is the first machine. Always remember, we are not disobeying the legal issues. We are not doing any illegal things. Part is because we should not inject anything. Anything injectable is avoided but non-injectable things we can adopt in our practice. The first machine died, hydro deep pin. So this machine is having the pressure of the air. What it is, it just gives the pressure to the air. Air pressure is there, and due to the air pressure, whatever a dry dandruff is situated on the scalp, so that will be removed. First etiology. Because see, given the internal medicines, reaching up to the Asti Dhatu, it could take a time. But patient wants something instant. I want something very instant. And the patient has to believe you, give something very instant. That's why now I'm telling you one setup which you can do for 1 hour, and within a day, you will get a results. First is the hydro deep pin. Okay, so this is removing your dry dandruff. Second, you have to use ultraviolet radiation. So ultraviolet radiation machine is liberating the violet color lights. So these violet color lights are antifungal lights, anti-dandruff lights. So here, first cause was the dry dandruff. Second cause is the oily dandruff, which is adhered to your scalp. So this machine is very effective machine. It removes the adhered dandruff and it kills the fungus. Second machine. Third is a laser lights. So this is absolutely safe, harmless. We can use it. So this is having the two kinds of the modes. This laser boom is having, one is laser light, second is LED light. So these LED lights, they are focusing on sebum production. Because the excess sebum is getting produced. So that will block the hair follicles and patient will develop a lot of hair disorders. So these LED lights will remove excess production of the sebum. Second is the laser light. What laser light will do? So that it stimulates the hair follicle and it will do the vasodilatation. It improvises the blood circulation. So that is very important. Next and very important is scientific combing. So what is scientific combing? So you may surprise that everybody is doing the combing. What is the scientific combing? Remember, we comb every day, but trichologically, we never comb every day. Because how to comb? So you have to keep the comb on the forehead, put little pressure. After putting little pressure, slowly you have to go front to back 5 times, back to front 5 times, left to right 5 times, right to left 5 times. Why to do? Because it is very simple. Each and every hair follicle secretes different amount of the sebum. This sebum is not equal. It is a different. So for example, if sebum is more in that area, there will be the oily dandruff. If the sebum is very less, in that area, there will be the dry dandruff. But if you use the scientific combing, so that sebum which is produced, so that will be equally distributed to the scalp. And as it is equally distributed, each and every hair follicle will get the nutrition and they will go for the regrowth of the hair. So this setup you have to adopt. When the patient is coming to you, first day, use these machines. Deep hydro peel, ultraviolet radiation, laser comb, scientific comb. When you are doing all this treatment 1 hour, on the same day, dry dandruff is removed, oily dandruff is removed, scalp circulation improvised, and hair follicles are stimulated. Patient will give instant results. Second is the patient will tell that my itching is gone. My hair fall is reduced. So therefore, in your practice, you can give internal Ayurvedic medicine. We are using only Ayurvedic medicines for 2.5 months. But externally, you have to adopt this integrate both to get best results. Next is, now this what we studied is for hair fall, dandruff, split ends. Now I am going for regrowth. Regrowth in what cases? The first case is male patterned baldness, female patterned baldness, alopecia totalis. See, success stories which I told you in the beginning. So all this in the success stories, we adopted this statement. Derma roller. Some of you may think that derma roller modern guy. Modern guy kuch bhi nahi hai. So this is the blessings of Ashtanga Rudaya. 5,000 years back in the Ashtanga Rudaya, this treatment is mentioned under the heading of Purcha Chikitsa. So whatever you are observing a derma roller, this roller explanation is given in the Ashtanga Hriday. It is specially mentioned as you have to prepare a small instrument with a four angula. So this four angula instrument to hold it. And at the tip of this particular instrument, there should be the multiple microneedles. And with the help of this multiple microneedles, you have to do the treatment or kesha shatra, venga, nilini, you do kesha kuttanamayava chikitsa. It's a clear indication is given in Ashtanga Hriday. Means you take this particular derma roller and by this derma roller, kesha shatra for hair fall, indralupta, all these conditions, nilini and the venga, melasma and the furuncles. All these conditions you have to do it. This is very clearly mentioned. And this Ayurveda principle we are adopting in our practice. How we are doing it? We are using the instrument, but the medicine we are using the Ayurveda medicine. See here, the mesotherapy. Meso is what? If you want to give the nurture, if you want to give the bulkiness to the hair, if you want to grow the hairs, in that condition, you have to adopt these principles. So you have to select the herbs with a madhura rasa, madhura vipaka, shita virya with a kesh. You take all these drugs, make aqueous extracts. Aqueous extracts will give the nutrition. Do a roller, pour aqueous extracts. Do roller, pour aqueous extracts. Likewise, you have to do it. Weekly ones, like depending upon the intensity, you can adopt 8 sittings, 9 sittings, 10 sittings, it varies. But here, this is for increase the bulkiness to the hairs. But stem cells or the stimulation. So here, what we have to do is, in the male pattern baldness, female pattern baldness, alopecia conditions, what is required? You have to stimulate the hair follicles for the regrowth. So in this condition, you have to take the alcoholic extracts. Alcoholic extracts of what? Katuras, Ushtavirya, Madhura Vipa. So this combination you have to take with alcoholic extracts. Why alcoholic extracts? This alcoholic extract to stimulate the hair follicles. Stimulation with this, with the kesha dravya. And we are using the kurcha. So this is what we are adopted in our practice. Okay. And we are, so whatever I showed the cases, only I am having my own productions. I am having my own aqueous extract, alcoholic extract, I am using derma roller, and that is there, the results are there in front of you. Internal Ayurveda medicines, either panchakarma or spa therapy, and this adopted modern things. When you are going to combine all these things together, success is 100%. Okay, so this is all we are doing in last 15 years. After doing a lot of research, so since last 10 years, we started one platform that we are training all BMS doctors. How to train? we are having the two kind of courses we are organized. One is a certificate course, second is a diploma course. So what is the intention behind these courses? See, so I am since 15 years, I am running these 6 clinics. So I am having a lot of confidence, treated several thousand of cases. So this knowledge I want to share to all the students. Let everybody can learn these secrets, they can adopt in their practice, let you can grow, and let Ayurveda can grow. So by this intention, I started teaching the students. Certificate course is of 2 months, and we are on the diploma courses. So this is a 3 months course. What diploma courses we are having? First is Ayurvedic cosmetology. In the Ayurvedic cosmetology, the beauty with us is we are using the machines, but medicines are Ayurvedic medicines. All extracts, all gels, all the creams, all the taila. We are adopting all these things. We are using the machine. We are performing the treatment and we are giving the instant results to the patients. This we are training you in Ayurvedic cosmetology. Our main strength is Ayurvedic trichology. Here we are training you the Panchakarma, we are training the herbs, we are telling you the spa therapies, we are training the machines, and everything we are doing for trichology. And we are giving the hands-on training to you for the patients. Then we are having the Ayurvedic dermatology. So this, the masters in Ayurvedic dermatology. So in the Masters of Ayurvedic Dermatology, we are telling you 50 diseases, how to diagnose, how to differentiate diagnose, how to think on each and every disease, how to give Ayurveda treatment. We are thinking that we have to take the support of the modern medicine. No. In my practice, I am using 95% Ayurveda. Only rare 5% modern medicine like yours, cetirizine and all. But we are very successful. And weight management. So these are 4 courses we are running: Ayurvedic trichology, cosmetology, dermatology, weight management. So this is the course is starting from 1st of July. The 1st of July we are starting the new batch. So those interested students can join the batches. And if you want to see the feedback of our student, you can go to our Facebook page, that is Dr. Shivanand's Ayurveda courses. There, the students at Globe, they experience the share, they experience their, about the courses, they share their opinions. You can go through it. Okay, these all the courses are presently available. You can adopt diploma courses and the certificate courses. Both courses are there. And recently, we are launching the franchising. In India, first time we are launching Ayurvedic Super Speciality Hair Clinic. We are launching the franchise throughout the India. Those who are having the interest to adopt other franchises, you can contact us. Number is given 7040-71004. And these books are available. Everybody should have these books. So this is these books are available now for sale. So this is my research, which I wrote, my all secrets. First is the trichology book, which is getting released this weekend. If you are booking it before 30th of June, you will get 30% discount. Second, very detailed book on dermatology, Ayurvedic dermatology. So this, everybody should have this book. This book will be ready within this month end. Again, if you book early, you will get a discount. Ayurvedic cosmetology. This book is also ready. And this one more book I wrote after completion of PhD in my sexology. It is in Marathi. Anandi Jivanacha Kamamantra. So these 4 books are available for all the BMS doctors. You can take the books. You can take proper training by doing the courses. And you can, interested can join for the franchises. See, we are having our own remedies, High Hopes Remedies. Those doctors, if they want to purchase the medicines, we are having the 51 products. Herbo mineral combinations we are having. clinically tested, research oriented, pure herbal. Products are available for sale. You can contact wherein the shampoos, creams, face wash, everything is available. You know, last is Innovation Skin Solution. We are having our own manufacturing unit. All the machines we are manufacturing. Like you want any machine, macroderma abrasion, hydrofacial, hydrogenic, musotherapy, laser, all the lasers, derma, all the machines are with us. So here, we are having the machines. And last and very important, I started my association. That is ACTA. It is Ayurvedic Cosmetology Trichology Doctors Association. So here, we are having the doctors who are coming there under one platform to exchange the knowledge. And we are sharing our knowledge for the betterment of Ayurveda. You can join this course. So for more contacts, you can adopt our Facebook page, Dr. Shivananda Ayurveda Courses, and you can be in touch with us by 704-070-1004. Thank you all for patient listening of the today's class. Thank you one and all for the class. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Really, it was amazing, very impressive, sir. Really great work.
Thank you.
So, very much, sir. Thank you very much for the nice session. Really, very interesting topic. So, I request the participants, if anyone have a question, you can ask, you can unmute yourself and please ask the question. Yes, please. Anyone? Please raise your hand. Sir, one question is there. Testosterone level, agar high ho, to kya karna chahiye for that purpose?
See, there is very important, nice question has been asked. Number one is Krishna Tila. Second is a swapa metal. These two, Krishna Tila is very, very, very effective. They are having, they lower down testosterone. What I suggest to all the patients is, number one, you can take the Krishna Tila, you have to fry it. After frying the Krishna Tila, you have to add the Gudha. Because again, Gudha is very important. It will, you know, it will increase the ferritin and beta. So you have to prepare a small laddus, and this you have to give it to the patient, which is very important. So this Krishna Tila is having a very effective role in lower down the testosterone. And second is a swapa metal. Again, the swapa metal is the European drug, and this drug is very for now. Vasu and lot of companies. So they are coming up with the swapa metal. So this drug is having a very good impact to release this dihydrotestosterone. Because if the testosterone is increasing, it becomes a DST, it blocks the hair follicles. So that will be relieved by this swapa metal. These two are the promising drugs which you can adopt in your practice. Thank you.
Yes, very nice. Dr. Himanshu, sir, please, you can ask your question.
Ma'am, namaste. Namaste, sir. Sir, my question is, if there is oversweating and fungus in the scalp, so, sir, what can be given to reduce the oversweating?
See, as it is very important, as I told, so I am just integrating these things. Just in this condition, you adopt only two machines, that is deep hydropeel, and you use the ultraviolet radiation. Do weekly one sitting, because see, if you are doing any taila benga, if you do some do pichu, again that fungus will aggravate. I think you can agree with me that. So this
sir, oil, I agree with you. Many times I observed after giving pichu and abhyanga, generally fungal increases.
No, why? Fungal because oil is a media for the fungus to grow.
Gee.
So we should not use any pichu, any oil. Here you have to use the machines. You adopt your machines, do a treatment, then instantly you will get the results. So that is what integration is a need of our.
Sir, one thing I observed that if there is oversweating, so daily cleansing of hair is required, especially in summer season. So, sir, can you recommend any shampoo which can be used for daily hair wash?
Exactly, sir. I was about to ask that question. Some tips like hair wash ke liye kitna matlab use kare kya?
Because sir, shampoos that are generally available in the market containing heavy amount of saponin and chemicals. These usually harm the hairs if they are used on daily basis.
Yeah, definitely. See, since last 10 years, I never use any market sample. I am having my own productions. This is for sale. And they're sulfate free, are they? So that you can adopt in your practice and it will do.
Okay, okay, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Dr. Shweta, ma'am, please, you can ask your question. Dr. Shweta.
Good evening, sir. So my question is, sir, for graying and graying of hair post 40. So many patients will come like, you know, I mean, at 40, you're still not expecting that, you know, your hair will become gray. And once they start graying, they really start graying very fast. So how can we help such patients post 40, you know, to in slowing down or reversing graying of hair?
See, well, remember one thing is very important. So there is one hormone, enzyme called as a para-aminobenzoic acid. So this is a hormone which impacts the melanocytes. It will stimulate the melanocytes to generate the melanin. And remember, testosterone is a hormone which is having a direct influence on this para-aminobenzoic acid. If after the 40, when your testosterone is coming down, so that will produce an indirect impact on your PABA. It's a para-aminobenzoic acid. So due to that, it will not stimulate the melanins, and this melanin will not come to the hair follicles and graying will be there. So that is a degenerative process. And if you want to remain your hairs good, diet is very important, and throughout you have to maintain your pitta in a very proper condition. All the pitta patients, so they are having the deranged melanins, so that will create the problem. Okay, so therefore, you have to adopt this thing. Correcting the testosterone will help you. If testosterone is very low, just increase the testosterone, then PABA will increase and graying will be reversed.
Okay,
so we have to do the reverse pathology treatment. Thank
and
you.
And sir, any external application for this, specifically for delaying graying?
Prapoundarika adi taila nasya as well as the shirojan. It is the only taila which is excellent. One more thing. Now the rainy season is starting. So in the rainy season, we are getting plenty of the brungaraj. Wet brungaraj is available. What you take the wet brungaraj, just triturate and do the avapidana nasya. It is very powerful for graying of the hairs. Avapidana nasya. That also can be adopted in the rainy season.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Sir, can you suggest some tips for daily care, hair care?
See, always remember one thing is very important. Shuro abhyanga, shuro pichu and nittalam. Weekly, see, application oil also, you know, what I suggest, if there is a dry hairs required more oiling. So weekly, 3 times they have to oil the hair. And in that also, they have to use very little quantity of the oil. And they have to massage a lot. Second is a pitta kind of the hairs. In the pitta kind of the hairs, they have to use twice a week oil. And in the kapha hairs, there they have to use weekly once. If you follow this particular pattern, everyday oil is not required. You have to follow this pattern. This also I am telling to the patient. And if you adopt, your hair follicles will be intact. Everyday applying the oil is also very harmful. Okay. So if you follow this, that is oiling is very important. And at least weekly once, you have to oil the hairs, do shuro pichu, and do some lepa to the hairs. These 3 things are very, very, very important to maintain your hair.
Steam, sir. What about steam?
Sorry? Yeah, that is the steam, that is Svedana. So you can, yeah, you can, Shiro Pichu is also kind of a Svedana. Other, you can take the cotton, put in a water, drench it, you can keep on the scalp. So that also can be adopted. No issues.
Yes. Dr. Mayuri, you can ask your question. Please unmute yourself. Dr. Mayuri, ma'am. Sir, one another question is there. Like Pitta Prakruti mein to early aging, jo Prakruti ka hi lakshan hai. They start the early aging due to their Ushna and hot properties of Pitta Dosha. So what we suggest in that early aging and early graying of hairs? So,
two things are there, Ahara and the Vihara. This is as I told you in the beginning itself. So Ahara Vihara is impacting on our coast. Once the coast is damaged, then it will damage the srotas and the dhatu. So in the dhatu, asti dhatu mala is a case. You have to correct the coaster. Correction of the coaster is adopting, means by adopting the proper ahara. Avoid all this katu, tikta, ushna, amla, rasatmaka dravyas. All the ahara, oily, spicy. So this one, we are eating more spicy junk foods and all the things. So that should be avoided. And second, very important is stress. As I told in the class, stress is very important. Stress will damage your, stimulate your vagus nerve. So that will stimulate your, you know, HCL, that will create all the problems. These two, stress should be managed and the ahara should be managed to get extra results.
We should start at early aging. Maybe हम कुछ आहार विहार में बदल.
आहार विहार बहुत important है. आपको skin अच्छा होना चाहिए, बाल अच्छे होना चाहिए, तो आहार विहार का solution ही है. आजकल क्यों problem बढ़ रहा है? Because due to change in your lifestyle, all these diseases are developed due to change in the hairstyle, lifestyle. So that should be corrected to get a good results.
Yes, sir. Yes, definitely. Dr. Usha, madam, please, you can ask your question.
Okay, two questions. One is the dosage of the tila laddu, what you told. And second question is how to increase the testosterone.
Or testosterone, indeed, there is a bara pada hai Ayurveda mein. Ashwagandha hai, gopshur hai, musali. Shweta musali, krishna musali, two musali zyada hai. And shweta musali is only for a testosterone. Directly, see, only gopshura, shweta musali and ashwagandha. If you combine these three together, you give it, it will boost like anything. All three are testosterone booster. Okay. So this, and supporting to this is Shatavari, Vidari, Balla, Shunti, Kokilaksh. Kapikachu, not Kokilaksh, Kapikachu. So these drugs will support to these three drugs. Then you can do it. There is no problem. That will increase as. So, but before giving this medicine, you have to check the testosterone. Well, this, once it is increasing, again, that will damage the hair follicles. So, but check first, then you give the medicines. What was your first question?
Dosage of tila laddu.
Tila, the equal quantity. You can take the equal quantity, gula and this you can prepare. Make very small laddu. Again, it is ushna. Okay. So, it is not ushna like the shweta tila, it is this. But it is a very good properties. It not only decreases the testosterone, but it regulates, it maintains the production of the sebum. So that is the beauty of Krishna Tila.
How many it should be taken, sir? Doses?
BD.
Pardon?
BD. Morning one, evening one, small laddu everything.
Which color, sir? Apana like...
Rasayana kala. Because we have to do the rasayana. Empty stomach you have to take and in the evening.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, one question is there. Dr. Ravi Agrawal sir is asking, what is the best treatment for hair growth? And some hair growth and some products for hair growth. So people want more hairs.
Hair growth depends upon the patient. You know, so what intensity of the treatment the patient requires. What I do internal medicine, give the internal medicines, along with that, perform the procedures. See, regrow the derma roller with the extracts. Use it. Aap kuch bhi lagaoge na, that will not give the results. Onion oil. मार्केट में ऑनियन खत्म हो गया, इतना ऑनियन
यूट्यूब में तो ऑनियन ऑयल के बहुत सारे वीडियोस हैं।
यू नो व्हाट इज कंटेंट्स, हाउ इट वर्क्स, आई कैन टेल यू वेरी क्लियर। ऑनियन कंटेन्स द एलासिन, पलांडो, इट कंटेन्स द एलासिन। एलासिन इज व्हाट इज रोल, इट स्टिम्युलेट द हेयर फॉलिकल्स, दैट इज इट्स रोल। ओके, लाइकवाइज गार्लिक इज ऑल्सो देयर, दैट ऑल्सो कंटेन्स द एलासिन, इट विल स्टिम्युलेट द हेयर फॉलिकल्स, बट only onion will not be helpful. So I can tell you very beautiful thing. What you can do, take the onion, garlic, ginger, this all the thing, and you can take the extracts and you do a derma roller and pour this. So that will give the miraculous results. Pouring the onion oil is not going to be helpful, because that should go to the hair follicles, that should stimulate the hair follicles. Until and unless your hair follicles are getting stimulated, you will not get the results. You have to use the derma roller in order to get the regrowth of the hairs. Okay, regrowth is only possible by derma roller. Okay, and products, I can tell you, since that 10 years, I never use any market products. So I use my own products, and these products are for sale. If you want, anybody is interested in that, they can contact us. Those who want to do the courses, products, we are there to help you out. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Sir, is there any role of age for the treatment of the such type of hair issues? So, what age matters? Or some type, hereditary, also some like graying of hairs is almost hereditary?
Yeah. See, as I told you, age, no. Age factor depends upon your level of the testosterone. So as age is growing, testosterone decreases, and that will create all the problems. Ayurveda mein pitta is responsible. In modern science, testosterone and remaining all hormones are responsible. So once it has been corrected, so only thing I'm telling you, if you are taking daily regularly ashwagandha, gokshur and the shvetamusai, your testosterone will be at the proper level. Early baldness, early graying, everything will be avoided. Because medicines and the lifestyle modifications is very important. Yes.
What you suggest about some parlor treatments? तो उसके बारे में आप कुछ कहना चाहेंगे कि कुछ क्या करना चाहिए for such type of issues?
No parlor. आपके पास आएगा एंड यू आर डूइंग द सेम थिंग विद द पार्लर पर्सन इज डूइंग, ये तो पार्लर में होता है, आपके पास आने का क्या जरूरत है? सो दिस इज नॉट, वी हैव टू अडॉप्ट साइंस. व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू टुडे इज टोटली साइंटिफिक बेस्ड थ्रू आवर आयुर्वेदा एंड दिस मशीन. सो इफ यू अडॉप्ट दिस थिंग्स यू विल गेट द रिजल्ट. डोंट डू एनीथिंग which is the parlors are doing.
Sir, Hastidanta Mashi ke bare mein thoda, just yes. Because people are very much interested in that part, Hastidanta yes. Mashi uses.
Hastidanta Mashi is told in Ayurveda, it is having 100-fold more action than your onion, garlic and ginger. It is having the properties to stimulate the hair follicles vigorously. They are having the same properties like the hairs. They have a, you know, danta is there, no? That is coming by the asthi. So as it is a part of the asthi dhatu will absorb, adopt, circulate very fast. So therefore, asthi danta mashi, but nowadays getting asthi danta mashi is very difficult. So you have to take the asthi danta mashi, you have to burn it. The powder which is coming, the black powder, so that you have to put in oil. Whatever oil you are using, in each and every oil, you have to put this machine and you have to do the head massage. So every weekly, twice, thrice, you can do it. You will get very good strength to the hair. You will get reduction in the hair fall. And along with that, you can observe regrowth of the hairs very fast. If you are having this Asthi Danta, you can adopt. Otherwise, if you don't have the Asthi Danta machine, then you can do this Narikela machine. I can tell to all my students, you can take the shell of the narikel with the hairs, make a small pieces, burn it, and do the bhasma. So this narikela mushi or bhasma, this you can take. Again, take the fine powder, put it in a oil that you have to apply to the oil. This is also very, very, very effective for the hair regrowth. If the patient does not get anything like the Astidanta mushi, narikela mushi is equally important in our practice.
Definitely, sir. Dr.
Shekhar
Patil, sir, is asking about the treatment of alopecia areata.
Alopecia areata. Again, we have to go in alopecia areata, go to the basics. First, to ask the patient about whether there's an hormonal issues are there, nutrition deficiency is there. That first to evaluate. Then do the trachoscopic study. See whether the hair units are there. Then you have to use the medicines. See, the patient khalitya palitya indrutu kuchu bhi hai. So our medicines start with the koshta, shotas and the dhatu. This principle we should not leave. So this principle is our base. Internal medicines, then external treatments you can do. And we prepared some of the creams by using the Solanaceae family drugs in all the alopecia conditions. As in modern science, they are using the steroidal creams. They use the mometasone and the probitasone, all these things they are using. In the same base, we made our own Ayurveda creams. Like we use the Gunja, Kantakari, Grahati, Eranda, and all the drugs in the Eshtimadhu. Eshtimadhu is a miraculous drug in the alopecia. We are using all the Solanaceae drugs with the Eshtimadhu and the Gunja and all. Prepare a cream or a gel, apply daily, do the massage. So that will give localized stimulation. You will get very good results.
Again, one more question from Dr. Shekhar Patil, sir. How to maintain the hair when patient has some issues like thyroid and hormonal issues?
See, always remember these things are different. If the patient is coming to you with the thyroid issues, so these thyroid issues, nutrient deficiency, that should be treated separately. What I told you today, this is absolutely only and only for Ayurveda. That is only for Kesha Chikitsa, for a hair unit. But if the patient is having some problem with thyroid, that is a different entity. So I am not telling you in this class about this. So that is a different approach we have to treat the patients.
Definitely, definitely. Sir, one more question from my side, that after like chemotherapy, there are many issues about hair. So please, can you suggest something according to Ayurveda?
See, very simple thing. I treated some of the patients. So I am having the collaboration with the oncology centers. So we are giving the medicine to them. So what is happening in the chemotherapy? So they are giving the medicines. So what it is increasing dehoshma. Interstitial temperature is increasing. So that increase the interstitial temperature will stimulate the dermal papillae. It burns the dermal papillae. So that will burn the hair follicles. Very simple thing you have to do is shuru abhyanga, shuru pichu, and the talam. So these three things are there weekly, twice patient has to adopt, and within a month, patient's hair fall will stop and regrowth will stop only by doing this. Because only what is, and also along with that, you have to give the internal medicines to pacify the pitta, koshtagata pitta should be reduced. And externally, hair follicles, all these things you have to adopt. You have to use the taila like the Dhanvantara 101, Pinda Taila, Bala Taila for the massage. Then again, for this Shurupichu, again you have to use Kshirabala 101, Dhanvantara Taila. Reduce the localized temperature. Okay, and the lep you have to prepare and don't apply. So if you follow this particular combination, you will be successful in all these cases. And I suggest to all my trichology students, every student should have the collaboration with the oncology department in the cancer unit. So you will get promising results to all these patients. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Just one or two questions we will take. I think your time is going up. So Dr. Shekhar, sir, again asked about the female pattern baldness treatment.
See, again here, why there is a female pattern baldness? Go to the basics. Again, here estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, and these follicle stimulating hormone, all things are different, changes. So therefore, the menopausal stage, the patient is telling you all the pitta lakshanas. Like the burning sensation, burning sensation, the hot flushes, burning sensation, burning micturition, palpitation, all these things are related to the pitta. Okay, in all these cases, we have to give the internal medicines to relieve the pitta. So once your pitta is under coming control, so then you are all the lakshanas will be improvised. Again, in this case, I can suggest you do phase one, phase two treatments externally. And internal medicine for Pitta Shamaka Chikitsa, that you will get the results.
Definitely, sir. Definitely. Dr. Pooja is asking about the sinusitis patients. Can we give the Shiropichur Tailam? So, what are the precautions?
See, this is very, very intellectual question asked by Dr. Pooja. Yeah. In the Charaka in the Pratishaya Chikitsa.
Yes, yes.
Very interestingly, Charaka in the Pratishaya Chikitsa explained a Kalitya. Why it is explained in the Kalitya there? Because with the patient is a chronic allergic rhinitis, kapha will increase more. And as this kapha is increased continuously, it blocks your hair follicles. And as the hair follicles are blocked, your hair unit will not get the nutrition. And as the hair unit is not getting the nutrition, the patient will end up into the Kalitya. Here, always avoid the Shiro Pichu should be avoided. Only Shiro Abhyanga and Talam, along with that, we are adopting the Dhupana Chikitsa, nasal installations, and Churna Nasya. We are adopting the Vacha Churna Nasya. We are telling the patient to adopt. They will get the results. But here, we have to give the medicines to relieve Patya Shadanga Kashaya, this Varanadi Kashaya, you have to give to the patient to take out accumulated kapha from the body, and that once this kapha, accumulated kapha is getting relieved, you will get good results.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. One question about the hair transplantation. Nowadays, people are very much like in Taluka place also, there are some people who are going for the transplantation. It is more common nowadays in these 5 years. I think it's really more common, much common thing nowadays. So, what is your experience about the transplantation?
I am also having the hair transplant.
Okay.
Fortunately, see, three hair transplant surgeons are working in my clinic. Means these surgeons, they are coming, we are giving the, I don't do it, but legally we cannot do it. Okay, so we are giving the patient to the plastic surgeons, they are coming in our clinic and they are performing the hair transplant in our operation theater. So there are two kinds of the hair transplant. First is the FUE. That is a follicle unit extraction. Second is a FUT, a follicle unit transfer. Okay, more popular is the FUE. Follicle, this here from occipital region, we have to take out the hairs and we have to implant the hairs on the expected region. Okay, so like this, we have to do it, and there is a good life is there, but only for those who are having the androgenic alopecia, the genetical alopecia. Those who are very prone to get the baldness, in those cases, you have to do the hair transplant. Grade 6, 7 and the 8, they can go to the hair transplant. Remaining cases, we can treat by the Ayurveda. Thank you.
Yes, sir, definitely. Thank you very much.
You.
One more question is from Dr. Shweta. What can be used for Shirolepa, and if it causes the cold to the patients, or the kafaj vriddhi, what can be added to the lepa, sir?
See, very simple thing is, see, as I told you, we are in a different kind of the lepas.
Yeah.
Okay, if there is a hair fall, we are having the different layer is there. If there is a dandruff, different layer we are having. If there is a male female pattern baldness, we are on different layer we are having. And if we are having the palitya, different layer is there. Okay, and layer, see, we are given the warm layer is warm layer. Okay, we are not a cold packs or we are not putting a cold packs. Okay, and this is for 10 to 15 minutes. And nothing within 10 to 15 minutes, your scalp is not becoming very cool. So, okay, only when you are applying the labor, it should warm. Because first you have to take the churnas, and in that churna, you have to add the warm oil and make it and you have to pour, you have to apply on the scalp. You will get very good results. There is no one labor is there. It differs according to the properties of the hairs. Isn't it? Thank you.
Yes, sir. Definitely. Definitely. Very interesting subject, sir. Thank you very much. It was informative, and I would like to request you for one more session in upcoming days. So it will be better. And I suggest for another session for the skin, sir.
Yeah, we'll definitely try. We'll try something in dermatology.
Yeah, sir. Definitely. Thank you very much. Dr. Nirmala, are you there? Dr. Nirmala Suwal, ma'am?
Yeah, she is there.
Please unmute yourself, Dr. Nirmala. Say something.
So, Dr. Nirmala completed a successful courses from me.
And she is very much keen about the practice.
Yeah, and she is very successful. And she treated several cases, she shared to me, and I'm very proud of her because she's doing very good thing in Nepal.
Yeah, definitely, sir. Dr. Nirmala, ma'am, please.
Yes, ma'am. Namaste, sir. Namaste, ma'am.
Namaste.
Namaste. How are you, ma'am?
Namaste, ma'am. Hello.
Yes. You are audible. You can continue.
Yes, sir. So today's session was very excellent, sir. You described each and everything, and it was a great, great seminar for every pathologist. And thank you, Silva, ma'am, and family for organizing such a beautiful seminar.
Yes, that's the range issues is here.
Yes. Hi, madam. Hi. She's the very much big fan of Ayurveda.
Thank you so much for organizing. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. So, sir, I'm sorry to organize again for the skin.
Yeah, we'll.
I used to be, but I am.
Yes.
Definitely. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. On behalf of Ayush Darpan team, I am really grateful to you, sir. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
So, thank you very much, all the viewers of the Ayush Darpan, all the participants for the watching this show, this psychology webinar. So, thank you very much, sir. So, I am ending the session. Namaskar.